Stato, io arresto lui. Io arresto lui. Mi conti? Everyone has a story. Everyone has a story. So if you want to invent the pattern for teaching, you have to sit down and rewrite your story. Make a list of the activities that your life is made of. What do you do? What are the things? What are the activities? Make a list of it. And by the time you make a list of these activities, what do you do? Reflect on these events of your life. Make a timeline of these events. By the time you create a timeline for these events, these major events in your life, like major events of your life, by the time you create a timeline for them, reflect. Reflect. That is about reflection. God gave us our minds so that we can reason. Reflect on these major events of your life. Identify the feelings that come with them. Draw a timeline of the major events of your life. Reflect on them. Identify the feelings that come with them. Does this feeling answer any question about who you are? What kind of energy does this feeling about this event that I've written? What kind of feeling does it bring to you? Does it make you happy or it makes you sad? Only you can answer that. Are we clear on that? Into that. By the time you're able to do that, what can you tell you who you are? And you are telling the right or then the wrong thing. That will help you to design your purpose. And then you say one thing. Celebrate. Somebody say celebrate.
Celebrate.
Celebrate the teacher. Celebrate the teacher that has been like a mentor to you. I don't talk about the teacher now. Somebody made you to have to. So think of one teacher that you know that has impacted you the most. What is that thing in that person that is remarkable about that person? What is that thing that is remarkable? Describe the teacher that has most influenced on you. How did this person shape your life as an education professional? How did the person shape you? I tell you something, if we lean on each other for social support, we are likely to be depressed and destined to work. If we lean on each other. You know, if our boss or your phone, by the time we come together, we have 10 temperature, we have 10 temperature. That is all I need to know. Leaning on each other. You can't stand alone. You need a shoulder. You need an encourager. You need an encouragement. You need somebody to motivate you, somebody to push you. Somebody to tell you, come, I've been there, this is how it is, come, just come. Just as, unfortunately, women, we hardly met all women these days. Because most times, we are flattered by jealousy. We are flattered by jealousy. It's a disease. It's a disease, and it's tearing women apart. Instead of you to celebrate a fellow woman, you just say, what is this? Men, they encourage each other. Men, they know how to drag one another. They are unfortunately women do not. May God help us. May God help us. And then number three. Make your well-being your priority. Are you feeling fine? Are you okay? Do you care for yourself? So many of us, we don't care. We don't get to check ourselves. We don't care about anything about us. We are not wrong. We are not machines, so. We are not machines. Make yourself, the care for yourself a priority. Make yourself a priority. Self-care is not lost. Don't say with a touch of. It's not a show, it's not a costume. That you care for yourself does not mean you are extravagant. It doesn't mean you are living a luxurious life. No, you
Wait, the recipe.